Welcome back. That's the S&P Nifty up about 37 points. Let's see how the market opens and where we take it from there. We have Ashwini Gujral, Mitesh Thakkar and Sudarshan Sukhani now joining us to take us through the technical calls. Good morning, Ashwini. What's the thought process on the index first?
Well, good morning. And for the moment, the market stays range bound. Now, range bound means that the previous session Friday closed at the lows of the day. Today, you could equally close at the high point of the day. So that way, the market is totally sideways. Now, we will start any sort of trending moves only above, say, Friday's high or Friday's low. But that way, I would think that the initial trade or thought process is to get long in the morning and expect that there is a bit of short covering and possibly a closing towards the high point of the day. That doesn't mean anything. It just means that the market is sideways and is basically moving violently on both sides. Obviously, you have to put stops because sideways markets can turn very sharply and very suddenly, as we discovered on Friday. So that way, today should be a mildly positive day.
Okay, fair enough. Let me toss the same question to Sudarshan. Good morning, Sudarshan. We missed you last week. What's the trend today? And just an added question, do you think today it will be IT that will lead and Bank Nifty will take a little bit of a secondary place?
Yeah, good morning. Well, Lata, first, the minor trend is that we are in a very narrow trading range with resistance around 11,625 and support at 11,550. It's just a 75-point range. So we buy at current opening prices and keep a very tight stop below 11,540 approximately. If this support range breaks, then we don't want to be long. Otherwise, we are there long on the long side for the rest of the day. To the question that IT should outperform, the answer is yes, which is why I also have Infosys in my buy list. It's just a correlation, that's all. And yes, banks and rather NBFCs should underperform. So that's the theme for the market today. Be long, expect some minor gains, keep a tight stop, go for IT and avoid NBFCs.
Okay, well, someone else who has emphasis on his buy list is Mitesh. So Mitesh, good morning. Before you tell us about your stock list, what's your own idea of how to approach the index today and this week?
Good morning. I've been advocating that we've kind of completed a leg of decline, made a temporary bottom around 11,460, 450 zone, then we might just chop around between roughly about, let's say, 11,450 to about 11,650. I think we hit the upper end of the range on Friday and then kind of came down from there. The idea is that this consolidation might extend for next few days, so we'll be choppy within this range. Try to sell closer to about 11,620 odd levels because my belief is that eventually we'll break on the downside. So that's the short-term view, and the medium-term view is that eventually we'll break below 11,450 and looking at newer lows we formed in the coming few weeks.
Okay, let's discuss stocks then. Sudarshan, good morning. You have three buys and two sells. Of course, the buys include Infosys, like you mentioned.
Yes, that's right. There is a mild bias on the upside. We are also at strong support levels. So it's better to be long. So ACC, which is now building a bullish consolidation and accumulation, and that's happening to many cement stocks, not just ACC. So ACC is a buying opportunity. We've already talked about Infosys, how Infosys is giving us the same bullish pattern as ACC, although they're in different sectors. So both are positional buys, not necessarily just for the day. And UBL, United Breweries, similar patterns, accumulation going on in all three stocks. So we are buying them for holding them for some days. And two short sells, one is PFC from the NBFCs. PFC has already cracked and broken down its support. It's now on a more longer downswing. And Page Industries, which is an intraday short, there's some weakness there. Maybe an intraday short is justified.
Okay. Ashwini, what all would you watch out for?
See, I have Wipro, which is a sell with a stop of 263, target of 248. BPCL is a sell with a stop of 350, target of 335. Asian Paint is a buy with a stop of 1345, target of 1400. Hero Moto is a buy with a stop of 2550, target of 2610. And Pidilite is a buy with a stop of 1170, target of 1220.
Okay. Mitesh, tell us about yours. You have a buy on Infosys and a sell on Axis Bank today.
That's right. I think Axis Bank has been actually, you know, kind of declining and has broken the earlier swing low of 763. So keep a stop just above that. 765 is what I recommend. 735 could happen here. Also a sell on Apollo Tyres. The indicator setup is slightly negative. So keep a stop at 190, half for targets of 180. And two buy calls, Apollo Hospitals. I think Anuj was mentioning this stock in the morning. That has some good intraday charts. So buy with a stop at 1347 for targets of 1400. And Infosys was a recommendation on Friday as well. Remains a buy with a stop at 714. Look for a target of 755.
Okay. More broadly, I mean, not just Axis Bank. Today, it's likely that bond yields will move up because there was a very sharp increase in bond yields in the US markets. These things usually rub off, as Prasanna said that even in his opening comment to us. So that could keep the bond markets, the bank stocks, a little under the weather, and also because of this extraordinary performance of Infosys. But I think we have the GNA axles.
Yes, in fact, the numbers came in on Friday, but they were a very strong set of numbers. It was one of the first auto ancillary players that came out with numbers. Revenue growth of 21%, margins up more than 100 basis points. Kulvin Sirat, the whole-time director of GNA axles, joins us now on the phone line. Kulvin, hi, good morning, and thanks so much for joining us. You know, I'm going to ask you about your FY20 outlook in a bit, but I want to understand what's happening in the tractor market, because you have clients like TAFE, John Deere and Escorts on your list. What are they telling you? Is there much slower growth anticipated in the quarters to come? Do you foresee, you know, lower revenues from that segment?
Hello, good morning, Sonia. Thanks for having me on the studio. So, as you have seen in the reports, you know, the tractor market has reached this 1 million mark. So, it has peaked basically last year. And, you know, so it is a cyclical market. So, we don't have much expectations to grow in this area. And if the domestic market picks up in this segment, then it could be at par to the last year.
Kulvin, actually, you have not done too badly in the Q1. It's a good set of numbers with revenue growing 21% and EBITDA as well, 31%, margins improving. How much of this can reduce in the remaining three quarters? Or at least one quarter if you have visibility.
So, the situation is like there is a demand increase in the North American market. So that is basically because of, for GNA axles, it's because of increasing share of business with the, you know, the existing customers. And also, we have been awarded some new programs. So right now, the order book is strong and it is good till December and we are fully booked. And for the, you know, the quarter after that, we'll get the image in September onwards. So we'll get to make that done.
So you can repeat the performance in second quarter is what you're saying. You have that much orders.
We are booked till quarter three, till December.
Okay, that's good to hear. One of your clients, Daimler, came out with a profit warning for the second time in the last 6 months. In fact, now Daimler says they expect a loss in the second quarter. Do you fear lesser orders from such clients?
No, ma'am. To Daimler, we don't have much contribution in India. And that has not affected us that much. And so far, you know, the payment situation and everything else is okay with all the customers.
Okay, I know this is a tough question then, but what is your best guess of your first half revenue growth and EBITDA growth? And what is your best guess of the second half growth? I know it's like too far away.
I can tell you about the yearly growth expected. That could be around 8 to 10%, you know.
On the top line or EBITDA?
For top line.
Okay, so you're expecting an 8 to 10% revenue growth for FY20. That's a big scale down compared to what you've seen last year as well as in the first quarter. Where do you see the pockets of pressure coming from? I mean, you said that North American sales are very strong, but where do you see pressure?
So basically, that is for GNA axles, the North American sales are strong. Otherwise, the market is not as high as last year. The market is right now down in North America. So that's how the situation is. That's why, and this is normal growth right now. And last year we had unexpected growth that was more than, you know, what we planned out before. So that's why this is 8 to 10% for this year.
All right. Kulveen, that's a mixed commentary from you. We are glad to hear that you've been able to grab market share. But the overall commentary is in line with the kind of slowdown statements we're getting from others. Thank you very much for joining us.